Hello everyone, welcome to another Quick Edit video. And this time I'm working on a blue hour image. In this case I want to slightly brighten it up and thus reveal some more details from the shadows and overall give it a little more of a bluish color tone. But I don't think this process will take long. So let's get started. In the camera raw editor I'm heading to the optics tab first as always and just activate those settings. Now let's go to the basic stuff. Also, I'm changing the profile to Adobe Standard and this will already slightly boost the shadows, which is really helpful here. Then for the white balance, let's try to set it to auto. That is way too warm, so let's just drop the temperature. I want to keep the blue color tones of the blue hour. Something like this looks pretty good. Now let's work on the brightness for a moment. Right away, this image is way too dark, so I can simply boost the exposure first. And this helps to reveal a lot of detail already. Now I think I could even increase the highlights without risking any overexposure. I think that's okay. If those light sources on the boardwalk are overexposed, I really don't care since there isn't any detail to work with anyway. Let's increase the whites as well. Alright, and I actually think I need to increase the blacks. And this mainly helps with the detail in this part of the image. Of course, right now we do have a lot less contrast. So let's change that. Also, I can add some more contrast using local adjustments, but first let's finish the basic stuff. I do want to apply a soft look here, so I'm dropping the texture. Also, I want to have some more structure going on, so I'm boosting the clarity. Okay. Also, let's boost the vibrance. That will just give the image some more saturation. Nice. Let's do the local adjustments. I want to start with the gradiated filters. You can see I have applied two for the sky part and one for the foreground. I'm starting from top to bottom. So first for the sky, I want to make this a lot darker since right now it does look a bit strange this bright. So here, let's just drop the exposure. I might as well drop the texture to make this area a little softer. Okay, then let's head to the second gradiated filter. Again, I want to bring down the exposure to make this area darker. This time though, I could also add some clarity for more structure. Okay, that should be it. Then let's work on the foreground. Here, I think it's enough to just boost the clarity. And this will get me some nice detail in the water. Maybe let's slightly bring up the exposure. Okay. Then that's it for the gradiated filters. I still have a radial filter left and that just covers the center part of the image, which I want to make a little brighter. Again, I'm simply using exposure. In this case, I could also increase the whites. And for the very dark parts, just increase the shadows a bit. All right, that looks cool. Next up, there is some color grading to be done, but not much. So let's head to the color mixer tab. And first off, I want to go to the hue panel. You might notice the blue colors do have a slight purple color cast. And I'm trying to fix that by simply dropping the purple hue. So this is easily overdone. I don't want to go too extreme here. I think that should be fine. Also, I want to head to the saturation tab and just boost the blue saturation. Just a bit. Also, I want to get rid of the purple tones. Maybe not completely. But something like this. All right, and then I'm also checking the luminance tab. Here I want to drop the blue luminance only very slightly. All right. Now in the before and after you can see I actually got rid of a lot of those purple color tones. And right now it does look a lot more like Blue Hour. All right, then let's also check the color grading. Here I mainly want to target the shadows and just apply a cold color tone. Let's see, I want to go into the very, very deep blue range here. But of course it's way too saturated, so let's drop it. And I think I could also drop the luminance just a bit. Okay, nice. Now the only thing that's left in the camera raw editor is the sharpening. And that's it. So let's finish this image in Photoshop. All right, first I'm using the spot healing brush to get rid of this thing here. It's kind of distracting. Okay, nice. Then let's see if I can add a little more glow to those light sources on the boardwalk. Herefore, I want to use a new layer and switch the blending mode to soft light. Actually, no, let's go with hard light. Then I'm picking up the brush tool. With the brush tool selected, I'm hovering over a light source like this. Hold the Alt key and just click in this area to pick up this color tone. That looks good. And then let's also reduce the brush opacity. All right. And then simply paint in over those lights. Very, very subtle, but very effective as well. Then let's merge those two by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. Then I think it's time to check the Nick Collection already. So let's go to Filter, Nick Collection, Color Effects Pro 4. And first off, I'm using the polarization effect to make those Blue Hour colors look a little stronger. Therefore, I'm playing around with the rotate slider as well as with the strength. In this case, I can't boost it very much since I'm losing a lot of highlights in the sky. But I think something like this looks pretty cool. Then let's add another filter right away by pressing this button. In this case, I'm going with the Pro Contrast and I just use the correct contrast slider as well as the dynamic contrast. And that looks pretty good. Now let's add one more filter and here I'm going with the Glamour Glow, but let me reset the saturation. Also, let's bring down the glow strength. Maybe we do need to drop the saturation a little bit. And that looks pretty cool. So let's apply it like this. All right, and that's it for editing this Blue Hour image. I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have questions left, feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.